Whether in the creation phase of your e-commerce site or in overhauling it, you must constantly think about the user experience you are offering your future customers. Over the years, e-buyers have got used to shopping online and above all shopping quickly and easily. It seems simple because you yourself are a customer of e-commerce sites, but there are however traps in which you can easily fall and which will be detrimental in terms of user experience and therefore conversion. Today, I will show you how to avoid three of them to optimize the user experience of your e-commerce site. Trap number one, thinking for your customers. Lots of merchants design their site according to their tastes or their preferences. The page structure, navigation, presentation of the catalog. It's a very frequent error which can cost a lot. Because your customer is different from you, and to offer him the best possible experience on his site, his buying behavior must determine the construction of your site. The navigation must enable him to follow a smooth buying journey, exactly as if it were a physical store. If you enter a store and you have difficulty accessing the products you are interested in, or you don't even see that they are in the store, you won't buy. Or even you will have a bad buying experience and you won't come back. The customer must be able to find his way around and have references points. It is also important to observe web standards. For example, users are used to having the site logo in the header at the top left or centered and clicking on it to go to the homepage. It's a standardized behavior. Like looking for secondary information in the footer, such as contact link or the returns and delivery condition page. To observe these standards, perform a watch, study your competitors, and analyze the major e-commerce sites. Note the standard practices common to all these sites and observe how they handle the buying journey. Your end customer will have a different buying behavior according to his age, his experience with e-commerce, and the type of device used, mobile or tablet or desktop. If it's a man aged 50 who buys from his computer in a rural area with a low quality screen resolution, he will not navigate at all at the same way on your site as a young fashion blogger aged 20 from her mobile phone. You must take into account your customer target, their habits and their needs, as well as the context in which they buy. A mother with two children will be less available than a single person comfortably seated on his couch in the evening with his tablets, for example. Trap number two, giving too much information. Another very frequent error in e-commerce and in physical stores is wanting to put everything and say everything at the first glance. Imagine a store of jewels. If in the window it presents its three most beautiful jewels in a velvet case, it will be perceived as a luxury and its products as high-end. But if on the contrary, all the collection is in the window with jewels jostling against one another, hanging from everywhere without breathing, it will give out a cheap image. This may be a deliberate choice, for example for custom jewelry. Just like the window, which must in less than 2 seconds capture attention, attract the customer, and invite him to enter to the shop. Your website must hook him in and make him want to stay and buy. On the internet, people only read if they feel the desire and the need. In a buying journey, they will start by scanning the pages, focusing their attention point by point. If your page is covered with information, images, banners, call to action, links and text, without breathing and without reading levels, the customer experience will suffer. The pages will be difficult to read and the customer attention will be solicited from everywhere and he will have difficulty following a smooth buying journey. Imagine a physical store with many advertising boards, signage and basket without there being any room to move. If you are a thrift store, this may be the type of layout your clientele expects. But if you are selling a high-end shoes, then it won't work. The risk is that the customer does not want to make the effort to analyze and goes to buy on another site. A few essential points for better user experience. Quality visuals, clear-oriented pages, concise message which go straight to the point, capturing users' attention on strategic points like the add to basket button. Trap number three, forgetting the stress factors. An extremely frequent UX fail on online sites is to forget the stress factor generated by errors or frustrating situations. Human beings are fallible and they make mistakes. There are millions of contexts in life which can lead a user to make a mistake when he is filling in a contact form, making an online payment, or creating a customer account, for example. If he is looking for a specific product and ends up on an error 404 page, he will be frustrated. If he enters his address 3 times in the same form because there is no dynamic error message and nothing tells him how to correct this error, he will lose patience, get stressed, and probably abandon his purchase, and then you could lose a sale and worse, a customer, due to a bad user experience. Don't forget that people are emotive and sensitive to stress. People make mistakes. Frustration is synonymous with a bad customer experience. Customers don't know the sites as well as you. Some people are not at ease with technology and buying on the internet. Others do not have always optimal buying conditions. Bad internet connection, doing several things at the same time. So, a few simple tips to avoid this type of bad UX. Test your site's buying journeys yourself. Do user tests, ask people to buy on your site and observe them. In the input fields, remember to give indications to avoid errors. Plan error messages which diffuse the situation and offer a solution. Make sure you use a tone which is not frightening. The wording is crucial in the user experience and it can both improve and damage it. Finally, don't forget offering an optimal user experience to your customer is not accomplished in one go. New features emerge and buying behaviors change. It's down to you to regularly analyze your data and watch the changes in your competitors' UX. For more information on starting your online business, subscribe to our YouTube channel and discover our e-commerce software. Thanks for watching and happy selling!